here, welcome and thanks for tuning in. My name is Dim Malmi and I'm a Nigerian YouTuber living in Lagos, Nigeria. So this video is going to be an updated skincare routine video. I've gotten a lot of requests for this. I had a skincare routine video up a few months back, but for some weird reason, I feel like you guys just didn't watch it as much as you should have, because that video answered a lot of questions, you know, that people would normally ask me. And like a day after uploading that video, I would still get questions from people asking me to do a skincare routine video. I was like, what? Is the video cost? Why don't you people want to watch it? But most importantly, I am doing another one because a couple of products have changed since that one. If you remember in that video, I said I was not necessarily happy with some of the products that I am using. I am currently happy with everything that I am using right now. If you've noticed, I've not had one breakout in the past month. I'll normally get random breakouts in this area and you guys can tell when I do because they'll leave, you know, dark spots that are just healing, but I have not had one of those in a very long time. And it's because of the products that I am using, so I'm going to go on ahead and share. So for my routine, I still cleanse, treat and moisturize. That has not changed. But then the first thing I'm going to be showing you guys is this cleanser here, and it's by Cetaphil. And I started using this about 2 months ago. This was not the cleanser that I showed you guys in my last skincare routine video. I was using the Acne The All cleanser at the time. That cleanser is really good. I used it for years and I loved it. But then access is a problem when it comes to acne.org products here, and it's not like they don't deliver to Nigeria. They actually give you the option when you go to their website to order, but then the thing is that it states clearly on their website that if you're ordering from Nigeria, you should order with caution because of customs and a lot of other reasons that they give. So I've not been able to repurchase the acne.org cleanser since that video. I decided to switch to Cetaphil, which is a recommended alternative by the guy who created the acne.org regimen. So this one is really good. It's really gentle and it cleanses the skin nicely. It doesn't leave your skin feeling squeaky clean or dry like most cleansers targeted at people with oily skin would, but then it gets the job done. You get a lot of products with this. You get about 591 ml, which is a lot. It normally sells for between 4,200 to 8,000. It depends on where you buy this. That makes a lot of difference with the price. I normally get mine from Ebano. I already cleansed my skin in the shower, so I will not be doing a demo of me washing my face. This is a cleanser that I use right now. And the next thing that I'll normally do is to use a mask. I don't use this on a daily basis. I use this about 1 to 2 times a week, and it's the Queen Helen's Mint Julep Mask. This is not my first time using this. I used to use this a lot when I was in uni. And ideally, you know, honestly, I prefer peel-off masks. I prefer them to these ones that you have to rinse off. But I've not been able to get my hands on some of my favorite peel-off masks. So I've settled with this because this is too good and it's not too expensive and it gets the job done. You get about 227 grams of product with this. I got this for about 1,900 naira. So it's not a lot for this amount of product. I'm going to go on ahead and just apply this on my skin. It's going to help unclog my pores, get rid of all the gunk that I have in my skin. And it's also just going to leave it feeling really soft and smooth. I'm going to apply this avoiding my immediate eye area. And then I'm going to leave it on for about 10 minutes and then I'll rinse it off. 10 minutes or till it's completely dry. If you're in a very humid place, it might take longer than 10 minutes to dry. But just wait till it's completely dry, then you rinse it off. So I think that it's dry enough now. So I'm going to go on ahead and take this off with a damp washcloth. Ideally, you should rinse this off, you know, in the sink or in the shower. But for the sake of this video and because I have shitty lighting in my bathroom, I'm going to take this off with a damp washcloth, but rinse it off. Okay, rinse it off. I always love the way that my skin feels after I use this mask. I don't use this on a daily basis, like I said. This is something I do once in a while. So it's not always my step two. My step two every day, of the week is this. I always go in with a treatment, and right now I've gone back to using the Acne.org treatment. I actually stopped using it and I gave my reasons why in my previous skincare routine video, but I'm back to using this, and this is because I've just concluded from experience that when it comes to acne treatments, because when it comes to over-the-counter drugstore acne treatments, most of the times the active ingredients that you get with them is either salicylic acid or benzoyl peroxide. I've just realized that my skin just responds a lot better to benzoyl peroxide than it does salicylic acid, so I'm back to using the Acne.org treatment, and this one has 2.5% of benzoyl peroxide, which I honestly think is all you need. You don't need anything higher than 2.5. So I'm just going to take a little, a pea-sized amount of this, and I'm going to work this into my skin, concentrating on all the areas where I tend to break out the most. So down the bridge of my nose, my forehead, my chin, no, not chin, cheeks. It has a gel-like formula, so it's not a cream, it's a gel, so it absorbs nicely into the skin and really, really quickly as well. So I'm going to wait for this to dry. It dries within 5 minutes. Trust me, it doesn't take that long to dry. So when it comes to moisturizers, I use two different types of moisturizers, and I'm going to explain why. The first one that I'd normally use, and the one that I'll be using in this video, will be my Blackop Ultra Mattifying Rebalancing Fluid. I showed this in my last video, and I love this a lot. I normally use this only on the days that I want to apply makeup on my face, and it's because it rebalances the skin and it helps keep oil at bay, but then it hydrates the skin at the same time as well. It is literally the most expensive thing that I have here. It has a very gel-like consistency. So I'm just going to apply a little on my skin now, and just over that treatment that I've just applied, and I'm going to let it dry. Okay, so for the other moisturizer, which I now consider my regular moisturizer in all honesty, this is the Yves Rocher Sebo Vegetal. I'm sure that I just murdered that word, but it's their gel cream, it's their zero blemish cream. I was reading the part that was written in French. This is their zero blemish gel cream. This Sebo Vegetal, however it's pronounced, range is targeted at people who have oily skin. So I actually got this to replace my Blackop night cream. I wanted to start using this as a night cream, but then I use it as a night cream and a day cream on days that I don't wear makeup. It has a very, very gel-like consistency. Looking at it, it almost looks like it's very thick, like a cream, and that's what I thought the first time that I ever opened this up, but then it's a gel in all honesty. It's a very thick kind of gel. It just sinks into the skin nicely. It doesn't leave you feeling greasy. It doesn't leave you feeling oily, and I strongly believe that this is the reason why I have not had a breakout in going to 2 months now. And I believe this because I'll normally use a cleanser to cleanse my skin. I'll use gentle cleansers, the Cetaphil, the Acne.org one, and then I'll always use this treatment because I've used this for close to 6 years, but then I would still get random breakouts irrespective of the fact that this keeps my breakouts at a minimum. But then I've never had a time in my life when I've gone without breaking out at all, and I believe that this is the culprit behind it. The active ingredient that they have in this is something called Bical powder, if I'm not mistaken, because it says that in the, you know, the box that it comes in, but it's not written on the jar itself. And this, in my opinion, is also affordable, especially if you consider how good it is. If you guys remember from that vlog, I bought this because I was looking for a cheaper alternative, a cheaper night cream, something that I could use to replace my Blackop night cream, the one that was selling for 16,000 naira. So I went to the Yves Rocher store to buy an affordable moisturizer. They had more expensive creams in jars like this, but I settled for this because of the price. I just wasn't expecting it to be as good as it ended up being. So I would highly recommend this, especially for anyone who has oily to combination skin. Check this out. So these are the products that I use to take care of my face, but then I have about 5 more products to show you guys here because I know I'm going to get questions on them. And the first one is the body lotion or body cream that I use, and it's still the same cream that I had in my previous video. It is a Nivea soft body cream, and this sells for about 1,500, around that price. I normally get mine from ShopRite or from Eban, or it's really affordable, and it moisturizes my skin nicely because I have oily skin on my face, but then in the rest of my body I have have normal to dry skin. This hydrates really well. I love it. To cleanse my skin from neck down, I like to use black soap. I already told you guys this in that skincare routine video, and I've been trying out a lot of black soaps of recent. This one is the one that I'm currently loving, and it's by a brand called Arami, and it is their body polish. I'm going to leave the price somewhere here. I got this from the Mose store in Lekki Phase 1. And if you're not West African and you're not familiar with black soap, it's just soap that we have here that is made with all natural ingredients. Some of you in the US and in the UK, you're familiar with this, but then you're familiar with it maybe in liquid form or in solid form as a bar of soap. Here, we tend to get these ones that look like this. They are really, really soft and gooey, and you just cook them up while you're in the shower. So I've been trying black soaps from different brands. I'm going to have a video. For example, the ingredients that you have in this one is raw African black soap, pure honey, lemon, extra virgin olive oil, rose water, ash, and a blend of herbs. So the ingredients are mostly always natural. And to take my makeup off, because I know that some of you are wondering, I still use Johnson's baby wipes. It comes in this packaging now, so don't be confused if you see this. It gets my makeup off nicely. I just use this to wipe my face, and then I go in the shower and I use a cleanser to wash my face. The last thing that I wanted to show you guys here is this Body Shop Vitamin E Overnight Serum in Oil. And the reason I'm showing you guys this is because most of you just ask me generally how I take care of my scar. If you guys have noticed, my scar has reduced a lot. If you're not familiar with my scar, I had a thyroidectomy in 2014. So I had a scar, a very prominent scar from it. It's been going down of late, but then one thing that I've learned over the years is to just make sure that that area is really hydrated. It helps it look better. It helps with the appearance. It just helps with the way that the scar feels. And I love to use this for it. So I just put a few drops, about 2 drops of this, and work it into this area. Let me just do this to show you guys. So I take about 2 drops and I just work this into this area here. It moisturizes it. It's really hydrating, but then it reminds me of baby oil as well. So yeah. So this is everything that I use on my skin. I hope that you guys found this video helpful, and I hope that it was a lot more helpful than the last one. Don't hesitate to leave any additional questions you might have in the comment section. I'm going to try and leave the prices of these things in the video and in the comment section as well. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.